simplicity, natural nature, abundance. If you take a look here at these trees in nature, there's a natural abundance that's always happening and unfolding. The truth is, we are that natural abundance. Just listening to the sounds and being in this presence of nature, one begins to remember a stillness inside, one that we need to revisit. To simply allow ourselves to let go for a while. The world is noisy. There's information everywhere. And it's coming at you from all directions. And what do you do? You simply go inside. Inside of you, to the natural place where all things began. If you take a moment in time and just focus here and let go, anything that your mind might be trying to tell you, oh, I should go do this, what am I doing here? This is the first level of training, is to be able to sit in one spot and focus on the sounds and what you see and what you feel, and allow yourself this opportunity, this gift, to let go. As you breathe with nature, and let go of your mind and your thinking, you return to a natural place inside of you. You become aware that our need to escape this natural state leads us to thinking we have to do something, or we have to go somewhere, or be somebody. But I promise you, if you let go, you will only find God in you. And it's okay to give yourself that gift of letting go. Of quieting your mind and stilling your heart. And telling yourself, you're just fine. But there's nowhere to go and no one to be, because you're already there. It's simply a shift in your perception, Master. shift in your perception of who you are. As we run and run and run to be somebody else, you, the god, the goddess that you are, has always been right there. Take a moment in time, if you will, to let go in the morning, in the evening, and return to the stillness in you. And when you do, the universe will surrender itself at your feet, for it has no choice. It has no choice to stop in awe of you. We all have this privilege, this time-space that we live in, to stop the clatter that's going on. To stop the clatter in our mind and let go and rest in the deepest part of ourself. You came into this world knowing more than schools or universities could ever teach you about the true nature of who you are, and what humanity is, and what this planet is. You. You're that free. Each and every one of you. To let go and come back into the cradle of true wisdom and knowledge that you came in with as a child. And I know nobody recognized you then. Everyone was trying to get you to be something else. But your true gift is what you came in with to share with the world. That's why it's important for us to take time to breathe in, breathe out, and let go. And become still. To practice the first practice is to let go of all the things you never were and simply reconnect with who you truly are. There's some great shifts that are going to happen. And they're happening now. And they will continue to unfold and happen. Well, you'll get to discover more and more the truth that you already knew what to do coming in here to this beautiful place. with the singing birds and the towering trees and mountains and the grass, nature, and it's abundant. Everything in nature is abundant. Every tree has its own seeds that create more. An ear of corn creates how many corn plants? Because that's natural. It's nature. And you have the ability to create abundance for you. When we get out of the world of societal hypnosis that tells us all the things that we should be and ought to be doing and gotta get done, and just let it go. Come back into yourself, to the true magic that you are. That childlike tickle inside for the love of life. And in that tickle inside for the love of life, it begins to spread out into your future. And then your days become fun. And tickly. And creative. And magical. Simplicity. Yes, Elaine. Our blueprints. Our original blueprint. We've gotten very off track. And it's become quite a performance and diversion and clatteriness, when it's really quite simple. Breathing, letting go, and loving who you are and fellow man. And connecting to nature. If we take the time to just let go a couple of times in the day, we reset ourselves. It's like what they call zero point energy, but it's psychological zero point. And we need that. Hello, Eva. We need to let go and just connect as a race. But don't think about the race of people. Don't think about all humans. Only you. Because you can do. And when you do you, others will ask. And then you can help. Just make sure you take care of you. In this space inside of you, you naturally know how to heal yourself. You naturally know what to let go of and what to bring closer. But in the top part of the mind, where everything is running amok, that mismanifests everything. We just need to let go. Drop in here, this place that you're feeling right now. With the sounds and the imagery. How long can you sit there? How long can you let go? And then we practice it throughout our day. Letting go even more in our everyday thinking. How long can you run with the top part of your mind shut off and just experiencing the sounds, the visuals, in a state of calm? I guarantee you, you practice this and you're going to step out of mismanifesting and into manifesting what you really want, your joys. If you like this video, like it, subscribe to it, and pass it on. We need to spread the magical consciousness so people can come back into their true nature. I'm Dwayne Hartman, and you can find me at dwaynehartman.com. Or here on Facebook. Thank you for listening.